Hey babes, it's Cass, and it's been a minute, and I have missed you. If you're looking for a no-commentary game playthrough of Fez, it was uploaded at the same time as this video, but it's also linked in the description, and there is an iCard above, because in this one, I chat a lot. Let's have a little chat about Fez and what the game is all about. Our main character goes by the name Gomez. Gomez is a cute little, like, 2D in a 2D world. I think the 2D world's pretty cute as well. But JK, because it's also in the third dimension, it's revealed to Gomez as you kind of play. And there's, like, little glitchy, I guess I would call it, like, little glitchy segments that happen in the game as well. And personally, the little, like, three-dimensional switch or capability that's revealed is kind of what personally sold me on the game to begin with. It definitely has more of, like, a Mario childlike feel, but similar to both Monument Valley games, if you've ever played those before. But basically, Gomez goes out on an adventure to collect these little golden cubes, and I think it takes 8 smaller pieces that you find throughout, like, the areas and the levels to create a big cube. The game is obviously in the indie genre and was released all the way back, I think, on May 1st of 2013, so I'm mega casually late to the party. I remember checking it out and hearing about it when it came out, but at the time, I just didn't give it a shot, I guess. The link to the game trailer and where to find the game if you want to play are all linked in the description box below as well. And P.S. I played it with a controller over mouse and keyboard, and I know that matters to some of you having that as, like, a capability option. Overall, I would probably rate the game a solid 3, 3.5 out of 5 star. It was cute, I enjoyed it, but I didn't enjoy it enough to 100% finish the game. So how can I rate it and throw up an uncompleted playthrough of it, you may ask? Well, obviously it's my channel, and I do what I want, but realistically, that isn't how I'm hoping to pursue or, like, complete playthroughs in the future. That's not how I've done it in the past. And not how I'm looking to, like, move forward with the next games as well. But, full transparency, I was 30 weeks pregnant while recording this playthrough of the game, and I just found myself, like, not necessarily motivated and was finding myself bored at the idea of finishing it. I think it was just a lot of the back and forth, repeating through certain areas. And honestly, several times I got confused with how to proceed forward or how to go back to the main area. And that just kind of became frustrating enough that I just didn't care to do it anymore. But also, if you have been here for any length of time, you know I love to read, and I have become pretty harsh with books this year, that if I'm over it or not vibing with it, I just DNF it ASAP, no apologies. And that's did not finish, if you're unfamiliar with DNF term. Overall, though, like I said, she cute. I'm glad I played it, and maybe someday I will see it through to completion, but today is not that day, and we move forward. September's game will be The First Little Nightmares, which I have played when it first came out back on the Nintendo Switch, but I never beat it on there. I don't even think I would consider myself having made it, like, a quarter of the way through, so it'll kind of be like a whole fresh experience again. And now I'll be giving it a shot on the PC, and I will finish this one, I promise. However, for the rest of this video, I will let you vibe out, and I will see you in the next one. Love you to pieces. Be well, babes. Bye!
Come on. Thank you. Mm-hmm.